In this video, we're going to discuss images formed by thin lenses. Let's consider a situation. Do you know how the images are formed by these lenses? Well, let's find out the answers to these questions in this video. Let's understand why we can see our images when we stand in front of a plain and curved mirror. In this case, the other side of the mirror is coated, and so no light can pass through the mirror. Instead, the light gets reflected and shows the image of a person. On the other hand, the images formed by lenses are not formed by the reflection of light, but the refraction of light. First, let's talk about the thin lens formula and the magnification formula. In the next segment, let's discuss sign conventions. The focal length of convex lens is positive, while the focal length of concave lens is negative. We can see the images formed in the figure. The object and image distances that are measured in the direction of light are always taken as positive. The object and image distances that are measured in the direction opposite to the direction of light are always taken as negative. We can see the images formed in the figure. Object distance is positive, and image distance is also positive. Object distance is positive, and image distance is negative. The sizes measured above the principal axis are taken as positive, and the sizes measured below the principal axis are taken as negative. We can see the images formed in the figure. Object height is positive, and image height is negative. If the image distance is positive, then the image is said to be real, and if the image distance is negative, then the image is said to be virtual. We can see the images formed in the figure. If the magnification is negative, then the image formed is real, and if the magnification is positive, then the image formed is virtual. If we use the above-mentioned sign conventions, the object distance must be measured from the object to the pole of the lens, and the image distance must be measured from the pole of the lens to the image. Let's have a look at this via this figure. In the next segment, let's see how the location of the image changes on changing the location of the object and understand how the size of the image changes with the change in the location of the object. If the object is placed at infinity, then the images by convex and concave lenses will be formed at the focus point. We can see the images formed in the figure. If the object is placed beyond the 2f, between infinity and 2f, then the images are formed by convex and concave lenses. We can see the images formed in the figure. If the object is placed between f and 2f, then the images are formed by the convex and concave lenses. We can see the images formed in the figure. If the object is placed at 2f, then the images are formed by the convex and concave lenses. We can see the images formed in the figure. If the object is placed at f, then the images are formed by the convex and concave lenses. We can see the images formed in the figure. If the object is placed between pole of the lens and focus, f, then the images are formed by the convex and concave lenses. We can see the images formed in the figure. Let's have a look at this table to understand the locations and nature of the image and their applications. Summing up, we have discussed the formation of images by thin lenses and nature of images formed by the lenses and uses of lenses in each case.